Hi, my name is Katie Maneen. I am one of the assistant directors of admissions here at Utica College. I'm also an alumni of Utica College. I graduated in 2013 with a degree in communication arts. Today we're going to be talking a little bit about UC, what we have to offer. We have a lot of different opportunities here at the college, and we're excited to share that with you. So a little bit of fast facts about Utica College. We do have an 11-to-1 student to faculty ratio. Now what that's going to get you is going to get you that one-on-one attention with your professors. They're going to get to know you, they're going to know you by name, and they're really going to care about your success in and out of the classroom. Average class size is about 20 students, which will make that very, very doable and very, very possible. We do have 16 of the top 20 majors that students are looking for. So coming to UC, you're really going to be able to find the program that fits into your career goals and fits into what you're trying to do for the rest of your life. We have 26 Division III sports, which I will talk about a little bit later. We're very, very proud of our athletic teams, and we would love for you to be a part of our Pioneer family with athletics as well. And really, we have an incredible value. We have the lowest private tuition in the Northeast, so affordability is going to be at the forefront. Now, for our popular majors, we do have a lot of those. We have the communications, we have the business management, but we also have a six-year doctor of physical therapy program. We have an occupational therapy program with a master's. We have an RN nursing degree. We have the psychology, we have the psychology child life. So there really is going to be something for everyone when it comes to a major. We want you to be prepared to go into the workforce. We want you to be prepared to go to graduate school. Now the application, that's always the first step. We are on the common application. So you can go on, you can do all of your school's applications at once if that's easiest, and you can add Utica College right to that. We also have our own application. You can go right to utica.edu/apply, and you can apply right on our website. We do have a fee waiver code, which is UCWV, and if you put that into the application, you won't have to pay that application fee. Just another part of us trying to make it as affordable as possible. So the application deadlines, that's always very important. We do have a few different application deadlines. We have the early decision, we have early action, and we do have rolling or regular admissions. Now what that all means, early decision is November 1st. That's the binding decision. That's the one where you basically sign a contract. If you are accepted, you will withdraw all your other applications and you will come to UC. Early action is basically the same, just without the contract. You're going to get your decision fast with both, but you don't have that binding contract. Now with the regular admissions, the rolling admissions, as soon as we have a completed application, we'll be able to get that decision out to you, usually in about 2 weeks, usually maybe 3 weeks, depending on how busy we are, but we'll get that out to you as fast as possible. The application requirements, and this is the same for everyone. We do require a high school transcript, an official high school transcript, so make sure that comes directly from your guidance counselor. Make sure it's signed, make sure it's dated. It's very, very important. We do require an essay as well, minimum of 300 words. We're looking for something that has had an effect on you that maybe is why you're choosing the major you're choosing, a big life impact moment. That's kind of what we're looking for. We are also looking for a letter of recommendation. Don't get one from mom and dad. We're looking for your guidance counselor, a coach, a club advisor, someone like that. We are SAT and ACT optional. For this year, we are also test optional for our PT, OT, and nursing program, but usually those programs do require those test scores. Now that OT, PT, and nursing program, like I said, is a little bit different this year for fall 2021 only. We are going to put a lot of emphasis on that math and science. We want to see that you've taken 4 years of each because we want to make sure that you're going to be prepared for the rigor of those programs. And in your essay, we want to read why you want to go into those fields. That's going to be very, very important. We want to know what your intentions are and that you're serious about joining these programs. Now for financial aid. It's always the biggest topic, but 95% of our students do receive some sort of financial aid. We are going to require you to complete that FAFSA in order to be considered for this aid. You can do that right at studentaid.gov. That opens up on October 1st. So what I usually tell kids is, as you're doing your applications, do your FAFSA. The FAFSA will be very, very important to complete, because as soon as you get a decision, you'll be able to get your package soon after as well. We are also involved with Raise Me, which is raiseme.com. You can go there, you can sign up for different events. It's a pretty cool program, but there are some scholarship opportunities within that as well. So the cost of attendance. This is always the parents' favorite slide, so make sure you share this with mom and dad. But we are very affordable. As a private institution, we do come in very much lower than most private schools. Tuition is right around $21,000, with room and board being around $12,000. We do have some fees bundled into that for a total cost of $34,368. It's a great value for a private school, hands down. We don't want you to be out hundreds and hundreds of thousands of dollars. That is not our goal. We want this to be affordable, and we want you to see the value in Utica College. Now, a little bit about our Student Life and College Engagement, also known as SLICE. They are responsible for a lot of the things that happen on campus. They cover the on-campus housing, which we do have a lot of different housing options. They are in charge of the student clubs and organizations. We have almost 100 different student clubs and organizations that you can get involved in, and we want you to be involved. They have leadership programs where we're teaching you how to be a future leader. That is our goal. We want all of our students to be leaders in the community. We want them to be leaders on campus. And they're also responsible for campus events. This includes some things like Squirrel Day, and they're very involved with homecoming, and they do a lot with the students on the weekends. We want you to be involved. We want our students to be busy on the weekends, and they make that happen. Now for athletics, like I previously mentioned, we do have those 26 Division III sports. We have 30 intramural sports as well. So if you're interested in athletics, but you don't want to join a team per se, you can do intramurals, which are for fun. We also have 4 club sports. And we've been number one in hockey attendance for over 10 years. We're very, very proud of our teams, and the community really comes out to support all of our teams, which is even better. Now, campus innovations. One of the things that I personally love most about UC, we're always doing things to better the experience for our kids. And that's what's very, very important. We've recently made Pioneer Village, which is a new housing complex for upperclassmen students. It's an apartment style, granite countertops. It's got the works, and it's absolutely beautiful. We also have Thurston Hall, which is home to our construction management program. It's a beautiful new building. There's a back room where students are able to work with materials and look at building options. We have the Todd and Jen Hutton Sports and Recreation Center. It's got an indoor track, it has a workout facility, and it also has a turf field for other teams to practice on, with tennis courts as well. We have a very recent renovated dining hall. There really is an option for everyone. The food is fantastic. If you can't find it in the dining hall, you're not going to be able to find it anywhere. We really have so many different options. We also have the Robert Brevnik Center for Business Education, which actually is held downtown in the city of Utica. We offer shuttles that will take you down for classes, but we're right in the hub of business. We want our students to be within walking distance of internships and different job shadowing opportunities. So coming soon for next fall, the Utica College Science Complex will be completed. It's an annex to what we currently have, and we're very excited to have some new facilities for our science majors. It's going to be really, really fantastic. Now, Utica. The city of Utica is an amazing place to live and learn. There's so much to do all around the city, and I always encourage my students to take advantage of this. There's the Art and Theater District. We have the Stanley Theater, which is one of the most beautiful theaters in our area. They bring in different acts. They bring in Broadway caliber shows. Really is a beautiful venue to see any sort of production. We do have professional athletics in the area as well. We have the Utica Comets, which is an AHL affiliate of the Vancouver Canucks for hockey. We also have the Utica City Football Club, which is a professional indoor soccer team. We have the Boilermaker Road Race, so if we have any runners, that is a 15K road race that's held every July. It's a really fun event. It's basically a holiday weekend here in Utica, and it's very, very fun. The Saranac Brewery, which is held also in downtown Utica, different soft drinks, different beverages. They do tours, and you can go down there to experience the brewery. There's so many different dining options, shopping options. Two of the things that Utica is most known for are the chicken riggies and the greens. So if you come to Utica, stop into any restaurant and you will be able to get Utica greens and chicken riggies. Now, getting to Utica, we do have a train station in downtown Utica. The Amtrak train runs through there, the Greyhound bus and the Trailways New York. We do have regional airports. Syracuse Hancock Airport is just a little over 50 minutes away from us, and we also have the Albany International, which is about an hour and a half away from us. We also have local transportation if you're looking to get anywhere around the city. We have Uber, Lyft, local taxis. We also have a campus shuttle. The Central bus comes through campus, and we also do offer a break bus, which is something you sign up for. It will help you to get home on different breaks that the college has. Now, College of Distinction, this is something we are very, very proud of. You can see the badges that we've earned. We are very, very proud of the work that our school is doing in these areas. We stand out when it comes to this, and we are very, very proud of the fact that we are named a College of Distinction, not only for the college in general, but for all of these areas as well. If you do have any questions, please feel free to always reach out to our office. We are located in the Sinkus Family Welcome Center. You can reach us anytime by phone, by email. We're always available. You can find our contact info on our website, utica.edu, if you go to our admissions page. And we're very, very happy that you are considering Utica College. And please reach out with any questions.